involved in the jewelry. Hallelujah. And baptism, the way who gave it back. I'm not talking about having somebody bound. I'm talking about setting somebody free by the word of God, which is the truth that comes to set the captive free. And you can't be free without the word. And the word comes to set you free. But if you're bound in your spirit, if you're bound in your heart, you won't pay no attention to the word. Hallelujah. How can you be saved if you can't be saved by the word of God? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Verse 12.
Amen. And as he entered into a certain village, there met him 10 men that were lepers, which stood afar off.
10 men that were lepers. Now, as you know, in that dispensation of time, leprosy had the same aura that AIDS has today. Amen. It was a forbidden disease. It was a disease that was incurable. Read.
And they lifted up their voices and said, Jesus, Master, have mercy.
Now, they were far off because in that dispensation of time, if you were pronounced as a leper, yes, they placed you outside the village, outside the encampment.
Yeah.
And the lepers would eat by people passing by their area and dropping off food particles for them and clothing particles and hurry up and get in the way, because the leper could not come into the same area with the clean people.
Yeah.
And they rung a bell and they would come into the village and they would say, unclean, unclean. That was to let the populace know that I have leprosy. And then the populace would have mercy on the lepers. But I'm going to show you something. You read.
And when he saw them, he said unto them, go, show yourselves unto the priest.
Now they came to the right place at the right time.
Amen.
Church, don't you know you're in holiness for a reason? You ought to thank God for you in holiness. Hallelujah. And I told you before, salvation is based on the individual.
Yes. Yes.
Not on the collective gathering. Oh, and then catch me here. Catch me here. Salvation is based on your individual relationship that you have developed with God and not on no crowd. A crowd cannot make you happy. You got to be happy for what God did in your life. Hallelujah. Where God brought you from. I'm so glad where God brought me from. Hallelujah. You can't stop me from praising him. That's why David, when he looked back, hallelujah, he saw he had favor back with God. He got happy and danced out of all his clothes. I'm trying to let you know, when God does something for you, you got to let God know. You got to thank him. Hallelujah. You can't sit back and sit down and say, Lord, I thank you. Sometimes you got to get up and get your step. You got to sing a song and say, Lord, I thank you. You got to clap your hands. Hallelujah. Lord, I thank you. You got to worship him. Go. Watch where I'm going. Read.
When he saw them, he said unto them, go show yourselves unto the priest. And it came to pass that as they went, they
received. He didn't have time to go through no changes.
Amen.
He didn't have time to grab me by law. He said, yes, I'm in a hurry. Go ahead, show yourself to the priest. You heal.
Amen.
Yes.
Read.
And one of them, when he saw that he was healed, turned back and was a loud voice glorified God.
One turned back. But he healed a multitude. He healed 10. He healed more than the one. But one said, I'm going back. I know I got my healing, but I'm going back and say, thank you, Jesus. Don't you know when you're in a holiness church, you got to down time, bow down on your knees and say, Lord, I thank you for where you brought me from. I thank you for what you're getting ready to do for me. Hallelujah. I don't have all my blessing yet, but I'm getting ready to get all my blessing. Devil, turn mine loose. Turn my blessing loose. Turn my miracle loose. I demand it. Jesus looked at the one who came back. Let me tell you something. Don't you think God don't see all this mess? God knows exactly what is going on. He knows how they're mocking his word, mocking his church, mocking his preachers. He knows that. But church, you hold on. Hold on a little while longer. I believe he said when he spoke to the one, he said, didn't I heal 10? Where's the rest of them? Oh, hallelujah. Only one had it down in their heart. See, somebody wanted the blessing, but they didn't want God. Somebody wanted to be in church, but they didn't want to be in a holiness church. Somebody wanted everything that they could get from heaven, but they didn't want to make no sacrifice. Hallelujah. You got to sacrifice to God. Thanksgiving and praise in the dance. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Oh, have your way. Y'all let me wind this thing down. Darling, give me Malachi 3rd chapter. I'm trying to wind this down. Hallelujah. Church, don't ever think that God don't see your sacrifice of praises. Don't think that he don't know what's going on at Shiloh. He sees every time you grab the paintbrush and it's 105 in the shade. He sees this. When you're on the roof, trying to get the roof right. You're trying to build up Shiloh home so that somebody who wants Jesus can find that secure place. And there together we can wait till the Lord comes. Hallelujah. Rejoicing and thanking him. Praise him. In Malachi, 3rd chapter, pick up in verse 10. Verse 16.
Then they that feared the Lord spake often one to another.
Spoke together one to another.
And a book of remembrance was written before him for them that fear the Lord.
A book of remembrance.
Amen.
Was written before God for them that feared the Lord. I told you in times past, these hypocrite, wicked preachers don't no more believe in this Bible than well, I would say the devil, but the devil believes in the Bible. I believe he says he believes in God and trembles. But they don't, these hypocrite preachers don't believe in the Bible. T.D. Jakes, Kenneth Copeland, Joyce Meyer, all these con artists.
Yes.
One day you'll stand before judgment and give an account for all the money you exploited from the people, yet didn't feed them the blessed words of life. I thank God I never wanted to preach for money. That's why I ain't got no full church. But I preach to save a soul. I want you to go to glory when your journey is over.
Amen.
They that fear the Lord
spake often one to another, and the Lord hearkened and heard it, and a book of remembrance was written before him for them that fear the Lord.
I like that part where it says, they that fear the Lord speak often one to another, and the Lord what?
Hearkened and heard it.
He heard what they said.
Amen.
Oh,
he
heard. Don't think that your praises and your prayers and your testimonies are in vain. Hear me. Now listen close to me. We may be small in number, but we are mighty in Christ Jesus.
Yes.
God is not coming back for numbers. He's coming back for people who have served him faithfully and dedicated. We can serve him faithfully and dedicated.
Yes.
If we make up our mind that we're not going to get caught up in the popularity contest. We are not like them. I shared the other night, the Bible says we're special people. Special means different. Peter said we're peculiar people. Hallelujah. Chosen for God's glory. Thank you, Jesus. Let's understand that when we come together collectively, let's not forget to praise God and to worship him. Before we start begging, let's start praising him first. Let's praise him first. Then when we get his attention, say, Lord, I need a little something. Hallelujah. And God will give it to you. Why? He wrote it down in the book.
again.